Hello, viewer. We believe God has been with you. Welcome to the Going Beyond program. This is the House of Worship and Healing, Deliverance Church, Dagoretti Junction. We welcome you into the Word of God. We want to enter into the service, and Reverend James Gikwa is ready to minister unto you. Open up your heart and your spirit, and just allow the Word to take root into your heart. See you after the Word. God bless you.
Faith is...
Imani ni
number 3
tatu
faith
imani
is a supernatural empowerment
ni kuwezeshwa kiungu
for victory
kwa sababu ya ushindi.
I say again,
nasema tena,
faith
imani
a supernatural empowerment
ni kuwezeshwa kiungu
for victory
kwa sababu ya ushindi.
Amen,
amen.
There is a power,
kuna nguvu,
that comes on you,
ambayo ushuka juu yako,
by faith,
kwa imani,
through faith,
kupitia imani,
and it supernaturally,
na kwa nguvu za kiungu,
it empowers you,
inakuwezesha,
to move towards your victory,
kuondoka ukielekea ushindi wako.
Somebody say with me, faith,
faith,
is a supernatural,
is a supernatural
empowerment,
empowerment
for victory,
for victory.
Someone lift up your hand and say, I receive,
I receive,
I receive,
I receive
supernatural,
supernatural
empowerment,
empowerment
for victory,
for victory
in my life,
in my life,
in my health,
in my health,
in my business,
in my business,
in my career,
in my career,
in my education,
in my education,
in my family,
in my family,
in Jesus' name,
in Jesus' name.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Give Jesus a cup of and blessed be the name of the Lord. Now listen, when this supernatural empowerment comes upon you, which is called faith,
wakati kuwezeshwa huku kwa kiungu kunakoitwa imani kunakuja juu yako,
you become unstoppable. Unafanyika
asiyeweza kuzuilika.
You become unstoppable.
Hauwezi kuzuilika.
They will refuse to sign your documents.
Watakataa kusaini makaratasi yako.
But heaven will stand there and command them to sign those documents for you, whether they like it or not, because power that is being released from heaven to have your documents signed so that you may move to your victory.
Bingu itawaamrisha waweza kupiga sahihi zile nakara kwa sababu bingu inakusukuma ili uingie kwa ushindi.
When they refuse you the tenders for business, heaven come and it makes those people who are refused with those tenders, they spend sleepless nights.
Bingu itashuka wakati wamekataa kupatia hiyo sabuni, itawasababisha wasilale usiku kwa sababu inakataa.
And the following morning they are looking for their secretary. What did you say the name of that woman is? What did you say the name of that company is? We want you to call them right now and tell them to get in contact with the CEO of the company. Why?
Kwa nini?
There is a supernatural power,
kuna nguvu ya kiungu,
that is working for you,
inayofanya kazi kwa niaba yako.
When they deny you the visa,
wakikunyima visa,
suddenly
ghafla,
a power comes,
nguvu inashuka,
upon those people,
juu ya wale watu,
we of the imagination,
watu wa usafiri na
wahamiaji, and they are commanded,
wanaamrishwa,
to call you,
wakuite,
and reverse,
waweza kurudisha,
they are verdict,
waweza kubadilisha,
because there is a supernatural power,
manake kuna nguvu ya kiungu.
Somebody say supernatural power,
supernatural power.
Somebody say supernatural power,
supernatural power,
that is working for me,
that is working for me,
in Jesus' name,
in Jesus' name.
That is very crucial.
Sasa hiyo ni maana.
Now let me give you this scripture.
Wacha nikupe maandiko haya.
So that you may understand.
Ili uelewe.
1 Timothy 6 verse 12.
Timotheo wa kwanza 6:12.
It says,
nasema,
fight the good fight of faith.
Pigana vita vizuri vya imani.
Take hold of eternal life.
Jishikie uzima wa milele.
To which you are called.
Kwa ambao uliitiwa.
Amen.
Amen.
1 Timothy chapter 1:19.
Timotheo 1:19.
It says,
nasema,
fight a good fight.
Pigana vita vizuri.
Holding on to faith.
Ukishikilia imani.
And a good conscience.
Na dhamira nzuri.
2 Timothy 4:7.
Timotheo 2:4-7.
Paul says,
Paulo anasema,
I have fought the good fight.
Nimepigana vita vizuri.
I have finished the race.
Nimemaliza mbio.
I have kept the faith.
Nimedumisha imani.
Can I say this?
Wacha niseme hivi.
Faith is a catalyst of victory.
Imani ni kichochezi cha ushindi.
Faith is a catalyst for victory.
Imani ni kitu cha kuchochea ushindi.
Let me tell you.
Nikwambie.
When faith arises in your heart.
Imani inapoinuka moyoni mwako.
Because it is the original faith that is of God.
But
listen to this. faith in God is the same as faith of God, because it comes through the word of God.
Imani katika Mungu ni sawa sawa na imani ya Mungu kwa sababu imetokana na neno la Mungu.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that is why it is not possible to stop it.
Na ndio sababu haiwezekani kuizuia.
God says in another place.
Mungu anasema mahali pengine.
I have lifted my word above my name.
Nimeinua neno langu juu ya jina langu.
In other words, as far as God is concerned.
Kama vile Mungu anavyohusika.
His word is more powerful than his name.
Neno lake lina nguvu kuliko jina lake.
That is why faith comes by hearing the word.
Ndio ndio sababu imani huja kwa kusikia neno.
When faith that is in you, it is faith that comes through the word of God, then it is unstoppable.
Imani iliyo ndani yako kama ni imani inayotokana na neno la Mungu, basi haiwezi zuilika.
Oh, it opens doors for you.
Inakufungulia milango.
You go in and you come out with the same faith.
Unaingia unatoka na ile imani.
And nobody can bring you down.
Na hakuna anayeweza kukuangusha.
I declare that is your portion today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Let me give you another one. Number 4.
Yanne.
What is faith?
Imani ni nini?
Faith is a kingdom mystery.
Imani ni siri ya ufalme wa Mungu.
That masters situations.
Ambayo inaweza kuwa juu ya hali zote.
I repeat again. Faith is a kingdom mystery.
Imani ni siri ya ufalme.
That masters situation.
Ambayo inaweza kushinda hali zote.
1 Timothy 3 verse 9.
Timotheo 1:3 mstari wa 9. Unasema
holding the mystery of faith.
Tukishikilia siri ya imani.
With a pure conscience.
Na dhamira iliyo safi.
Listen to me my dear brethren.
Nisikize wapendwa.
Faith is a kingdom mystery.
Imani ni siri ya ufalme.
That masters
ambayo inaweza kutawala juu ya hali.
Amen.
Amen.
Now in the natural,
katika ukawaida,
when somebody is faced with a very very hard situation,
wakati mtu amekumbana na hali ambazo ni ngumu,
for example,
kwa mfano,
the way we are seated here,
vile ambavyo tumekaa hapa,
a lion just appears.
Simba aingie tu pa.
A lion appear.
Simba aingie hapa.
Or a bear.
Ama dubu.
Or a bear.
Ama dubu.
What will happen?
Nini itafanyika?
We will all act differently.
Zote tutafanya mambo tofauti tofauti.
Others will fail and faint.
Wengine watasema, oh, dunia hii ni meza.
Oh, yes. They are finished.
Wameisha.
Others,
wengine,
they will be on top of this, on the roof of the tent.
Wataninginia juu ya paa hili la hema hii.
In fact, they will be sitting there.
Watakuwa wakikaa juu. Ujui wamepanda aje huko.
With their eyes closed.
Na macho yao yamefungwa.
Others will say, mami, mami, mami.
Na watasema, mami, 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 mami.
And close their eyes and froze on the seat.
Na wafunge macho waseme dunia iwameze.
Others.
Wengine.
Why? Because there is what we call.
Kwa sababu.
The adrenaline levels.
Kiwango cha adrenaline.
Well, that rises in your blood.
Inainuka kwenye damu yako.
It enables you to act differently according to the adversity of the situation.
Ambayo inakuwezesha kutenda tofauti kulingana na mambo ambayo yamekukumba.
Are you understanding what you are saying?
Unaelewa.
Bwana asifiwe.
Bwana asifiwe.
Now faith,
imani,
is a kingdom mystery.
Ni siri ya ufalme.
That masters situation.
Ambayo inatawala.
When the situation comes that is so difficult,
hali zikikuja ambazo ni ngumu,
that faith,
hiyo imani,
it arises in you.
Inainuka ndani yako.
And it says,
inasema,
I don't care how difficult the situation is.
Sijali hii hali iko ngumu kwa njia gani.
It is not going to bring me down.
Haitaniangusha.
I am going to emerge victorious.
Nitainuka mshindi.
I am going to overcome.
Nitashinda.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many understand what you are saying?
Mnaelewa.
Your child,
mtoto wako,
has been admitted to school.
Ameitwa shule.
In fact, next week kids are supposed to go back to school.
Wiki ijayo watoto wanarudi shule.
You need 50,000 to pay school fees.
Unahitaji 50,000 ulipie karo.
You don't have the money.
Hauna dough.
You don't have hope.
Hauna tumaini.
What happened?
Nini nafanyika?
Faith is a kingdom mystery.
Imani ni siri ya kifalme.
That masters situation.
Ambayo inatawala juu ya hali.
So what happened?
Nini nafanyika?
With the hand of faith.
Na mkono wa imani.
At the gates that situation.
Unaingia unashika ile hali.
Faith masters that 50,000 situation.
Imani inatawala juu ya hiyo hali ya 50,000.
And it makes the 50,000 situation to bow.
Na inasababisha hiyo hali ya 50,000 iweze kuinama.
And it makes the way for the 50,000 to be available, to be available for you.
Na inasababisha kuwe na njia zile 50,000 zipatikane kwako.
How many understand mwana sifiwe? Listen to this. Silver and gold,
dhahabu na fedha,
they belong to God.
Ni za Mungu.
Cattle na 1,000 in
ng'ombe katika milima
yake, they belong to God.
Ni za Mungu.
God owns everything.
Mungu anamiliki kila kitu.
Now faith,
imani,
it gives you access,
inakupa kufikia,
into the riches of heaven,
ndani ya utajiri wa mbinguni.
But first of all,
lakini kwanza,
it got to rise up,
lazima inuke,
and master that situation,
na iweze kutawala juu ya ile hali.
For example,
kwa mfano,
maybe you go to the doctor,
labda unaenda kwa daktari,
and they do one test after another,
anafanya majaribio moja hadi nyingine,
and they diagnose you,
na anaweza kukudadisi,
and they say,
anasema,
you have got a problem that is developing your body.
Una shida ambayo inajiumba ndani ya mwili wako.
We are sorry to tell you,
tunasamahani kukuambia,
that your kidneys are slightly failing. May God forbid that to happen to anybody.
Figo
in Jesus name.
Inafeli, Mungu asikubali ifanyike kwa yeyote.
But when that happened,
lakini hiyo inapofanyika,
because it happened to people,
maana inafanyika kwa watu,
like you and me,
kama wewe na mimi,
you as a child of God,
wewe kama mwana wa Mungu,
the difference is,
tofauti ni hii,
you have been equipped with a sense of faith,
wewe umepewa kifaa cha imani,
with the power of faith,
na nguvu ya imani.
Faith is a spiritual mystery. It is a spiritual mystery that masters situations and causes the situation to bow.
Imani ni siri ya kifalme ambayo inatawala juu ya hali zozote zinazokuja maishani mwako na kuzisababisha
zinane. So when the doctor tell you that,
daktari anapokuambia,
what happened?
Inafanyikaje?
The faith sense in you, it rises up.
Imani iliyo ndani yako inainuka.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It masters the situation.
Inatawala juu ya ile hali.
It masters the situation.
Inatawala na kutiisha ile
hali. And it hold the situation by the neck.
Na inatiisha, inashika ile hali kwenye shingo.
Wewe
inaanza kuinyonga. Inaanza kuinyonga.
And it says,
inasema,
you kidney situation,
wewe hali ya figo,
you have no authority over my body,
juu ya mwili wangu.
You kidney situation,
wewe hali ya figo,
you got to die,
lazima ufe,
from the root,
kutoka mizizi.
Come on, come on. And because faith,
na kwa sababu imani,
it has mastered that situation,
imeweza kutiisha ile hali,
it is able to make it to bow,
inaweza kuifanya iname,
and it is able to break it. That is how faith work. How many understand what I'm saying? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Somebody say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
And by faith.
And by faith.
I declare. Every situation. That rises against me. Right now.
Right now.
Bow.
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 Die.
Bow.
Die. Somebody say, every virus.
Every
germ. In my body.
In my body.
By faith. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
That is a mystery. Nobody can explain. How many understand what I'm saying? Nobody can explain how God heals his people by faith. Nobody can explain how somebody who was supposed to undergo a surgery in hospital,
mtu ambaye alipaswa kupitia upasuaji hospitalini,
and they believe God for healing,
na naamini Mungu kwa uponyaji,
and God turns around the situation and finally you don't end up being operated,
na Mungu anageuza ile hali na hauishi kupasuliwa,
and your body is totally whole,
na mwili wako unakuwa mzima.
How many understand what I'm saying? And I have prayed for many people in that kind of a situation.
Nimeombea watu wengi katika hali kama ile.
Bwana asifiwe.
Yesu asifiwe.
Including a young girl here, Makena. I don't know where Makena is.
Makena sio yuko wapi?
Makena, she is supposed to be around here. Bwana tukuzwe sana. Yeah, there she is. Makena is there.
Kamelala.
Very well. Bring this girl. Just bring her to me.
Mlete.
Bwana asifiwe. She's one of the miracles I'm talking about.
Yeah,
leave alone her, my own self.
Mimi mwenyewe.
I am a miracle.
Mimi ni muujiza.
At a given point the doctor said I have to be operated.
Wakati fulani daktari alisema nipasuliwe.
I said,
nikasema,
I am not ready to be operated. I don't believe the report of the doctor. I will stand with the faith in the word of the Lord. Bwana asifiwe sana. And here I am many years after, and that problem was finished from the root in Jesus' mighty name.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Bwana tukuzwe sana. This guy here,
huyu binti hapa,
this guy here had a number of appointments at Kenyatta Hospital.
Alikuwa na mialiko kadhaa kwenye hospitali ya Kenyatta.
This miracle doctor here,
huyu binti wa muujiza.
Bwana tukuzwe sana. This one here,
huyu hapa,
the insurance company,
kampuni ya insurance,
when they heard what was going on,
waliposikia yaliyokuwa,
they jumped to the case. They said,
wakasema,
we are not able to cover the child. The bill was coming to about 600,000-700,000 Kenya shilling.
Ilikuwa inafikia 600,000-700,000 shilingi ya Kenya.
That is what was supposed to be paid.
Hiyo ndio ilikuwa inapaswa kulipa.
The parents could come to me,
wazazi wakaja,
I told them, we are canceling that operation in the name of
tunapingana na ule upasuaji katika jina la Yesu.
This girl was 1 year then.
Alikuwa na mwaka mmoja.
Here she is.
Yuko hapa.
Very beautiful.
Akiwa mrembo.
And doing very well. Pigeni Yesu makofi. Blessed be the holy name of the Lord. Bwana Yesu atukuzwe sana.
Bwana asifiwe.
And many, 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 many others.
Na mambo mengi mengi.
Faith.
Imani.
As a supernatural mystery that masters situation. Number 5.
Nambali ya 5. Imani.
As a spiritual force.
Ni nguvu ya kiungu ya kiroho.
Faith is a spiritual force.
Imani ni nguvu ya kiroho
that gives victory,
ambayo peana ushindi
in spiritual warfare,
katika vita vya kiroho.
Faith,
imani,
is a spiritual force.
Ni nguvu ya kiroho.
Is a spiritual power.
Ni nguvu ya kiroho, ni
shati that gives you victory.
Inayokupa ushindi
in warfare,
katika vita vya
kiroho. In fact, in Ephesians chapter 6 verse 16,
Waefeso sura ya 6 mstari 16,
when Paul is talking about the full armor,
Paulo anapoongea kuhusu silaha kamili,
he says verse 16,
anasema mstari wa 16,
Ephesians 6:16, in addition to all this,
pamoja na haya yote,
everybody read with me, 1 2 3, in addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Amen.
Amen.
So, faith,
imani,
it is a force.
Ni nguvu.
It is a power.
Ni uweza.
It is a spiritual force.
Ni nguvu ya kiroho.
It is a weapon.
Ni silaha.
That gives you victory.
Ikupayo ushindi.
In warfare.
Katika vita vya.
Now, the good thing with this one,
jambo nzuri na hii,
is that you are supposed to hold it.
Unapaswa tu kuishikilia like a shield.
Kama ngao. It is called the shield of faith.
Inaitwa ngao ya imani.
The shield of faith.
Ngao ya imani.
Tell your neighbor the shield of faith.
Ambia jirani yako ngao ya imani.
Tell your neighbor the shield of faith.
The shield of faith.
Tell your neighbor the shield of faith.
The shield of faith.
Now what is faith? What is a shield supposed to do in war?
Ni gao ni ya kufanya nini katika vita?
It is to protect you.
Ni kuzuia tu.
So somebody has thrown the arrow.
Tu amerusha mkuki.
Hey!
Hey!
Bwana asifiwe.
Asifiwe Bwana.
The arrow of discouragement.
Mshale wa kufedheheka moyo.
Before it hits.
Kabla ukugonge.
You put the shield.
Unaweka gao.
Hey!
Aha.
And the shield.
Na ngao.
And it hits the arrow. And it falls to the ground. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then the enemy,
adui,
he is not through with you.
Hajamalizana na wewe.
He throws the arrow of jealousy and hate.
Anarusha mshale wa
wivu
na chuki na
usuda. This one is a scarred.
Sasa hii ni scarred.
It is intended once it hit you, you will never rise again.
Sasa hii ni kobora, imepangwa ikikugonga hutainuka tena.
It is developing in your office.
Inatengenezwa
in your family, in your neighbors,
majirani,
in your family members, in your relatives.
Watu wa jamaa yako.
They are coming together. They want to throw one.
Wanataka kurusha
which will finish you for all.
Moja ikumalize mara
moja. But you have the shield. The shield. The shield. The shield of faith.
Lakini unangao ngao ngao ya imani.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So when the arrow is thrown,
wakati mshale umerushwa,
what are you supposed to do?
Unapaswa kufanya nini?
You are supposed to arrest it.
Unafaa ushike.
That tells me you must have the ability to discern in the spirit what the enemy is planning and which arrow and at what time the enemy is about to throw an arrow.
Unapaswa uwe na upambanuzi wa kiroho kuhusu yale mambo adui anapanga na mshale umerushwa wapi na ni wakati gani wa kunyaka.
That is why spiritual discernment is very important.
Kwa sababu uwezo wa kupambanua kiroho ni wa maana.
There are people who you call your friends.
Kuna watu utaita marafiki.
And without discernment,
na bila kupambanuliwa,
they will finish you before you know.
Watakuangamiza kabla ujue.
Yet you ate with them.
Ilihali munakula nao.
You dined with them.
Munakula pamoja.
You lived together.
Munaishi pamoja.
They schemed and they finished the scheming even before you know the scheming is going on.
Walikupangia hila, wakamaliza kupanga hata kabla ujue kunapangwa.
That is why discernment is important.
Kwa sababu kupambanua ni kwa maana.
But once you have discernment,
lakini ukiwa na ule upambanuzi,
what will help you?
Nini itakusaidia?
Is the shield of faith.
Ni ngao ya imani.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
with the shield of faith,
kwa ngao ya imani,
you will be able to quench and put down all the arrows of the enemy.
Unaweza kuzima mishale yote ya adui.
There are those that are coming from this direction. This direction. That direction. That direction. There are those that are coming during the day. There are those that are coming during the night.
Kuna ile inapeperusha usiku.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many understand what you are saying? Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And find a reason to the good thing about faith.
We shall esikiza mazuri kuhusu imani.
As a shield.
Kama ngao.
You are supposed to start with a shield.
Unapaswa uanze na ngao.
Go through the warfare.
Upitia vita.
And by the end of it all.
We shall.
You still remain holding your shield.
Bado ubakie umeshikilia ngao.
You don't lose it.
Haupotezi.
You go to the war.
Unaenda kwa vita.
Fight the battle.
Unapigana vita.
Use the shield.
Unatumia ngao.
To quench the arrows.
Kuzuia mishale.
And finally.
We show
you don't lose your shield.
Haupotezi ngao yako.
You come back with your shield.
Unarudi na ngao yako.
That means.
Hiyo inamaanisha.
Don't lose the faith.
Usipoteze imani.
That is why Paul said.
Kwa sababu Paulo anasema.
I have fought the fight.
Nimepigana vita.
And finally I have preserved the faith.
Na mwishowe nimedumisha imani.
Don't lose, tell your neighbor, don't lose the faith.
Don't lose the faith.
Mwambie usipoteze imani. Usipoteze imani. Tell them don't lose the faith.
Poteze imani.
Bwana asifiwe sana. Tell them come back with the faith.
Ukirudi
tell them come back with the shield.
Unaporudi rudi.
Tell them come back with the shield.
Usipoteze ngao.
Amen.
Amen.
Because the most likely, the worst thing that can happen.
Jambo lile mbaya linaweza fanyika.
It's when the enemy attack.
Ni wakati adui ameshambulia.
And the arrow.
Na mshale.
It hits on the shield.
Unagonga ngao.
And your shield fall.
Ngao inaanguka.
And finally.
Mwishowe.
You decide to run away.
Unaambua kutoroka.
And you don't have a shield.
Na hauna ngao.
Now it means you have lost faith.
Sasa umepoteza imani.
Are you understanding?
Unaenda.
So what will happen?
Nini inafanyika?
It is very easy for the enemy to get you.
Mishale ya mgongo utalimwa.
But as long as you hold on to faith.
Ukishikilia imani.
As a shield.
Kama ngao.
As long as you hold on. Faith as a shield. My sister, no matter what happens in your marriage, no matter what happens in the place of work, no matter what happens in your health, no matter happens in your finances, hold on to the shield of faith. Hold on to the shield. 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 Put it on your head. Put it on your breast, on your chest. Put it on your lower loins. Remain in faith. Remain in faith. No matter what happens. Because that is a prerequisite for your victory. How many are together with me? And finally, faith is a master key.
Imani ni funguo.
To unlimited possibility.
Ya kufungua nafasi ambazo hazina mwisho.
Turn to your neighbor, tell them faith is a master key.
Faith is a master key.
To unlimited possibility.
To unlimited possibility.
Tell them with the faith.
With the faith.
You can enter any door.
You can enter any door.
Because you have the master key.
Because you have the master key.
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 Faith is a master key.
Imani ni funguo ya kufungua.
To unlimited possibilities.
Kwa nafasi ambazo hazina kikomo mingi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Listen to me. God has given us opportunities in life.
Mungu ametupatia nafasi maishani.
But there is no way to get into the door of those opportunities unless you do it by faith.
Lakini hakuna nafasi ya kuingia katika zile milango isipokuwa uende kule kwa imani.
Mark chapter 9 verse 3.
Marko 9 mstari wa
3. Everything is possible for him who believes.
Chochote kinawezekana kwa aaminie.
That is Mark 9:23.
Marko 9:23.
Everything is possible.
Kila kitu chawezekana.
Everything is possible.
Kila kitu kinawezekana.
Everything is possible.
Kila kitu kinawezekana.
Can't you somebody tell them everything is possible?
Everything is possible.
Tell them everything is possible.
Everything is possible.
With the faith.
With the faith.
Tell them with the faith.
With the faith.
Everything is possible.
Everything is possible.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Matthew 17:20.
Mathayo 17 mstari wa 20.
He replied.
Akajibu.
Because you have so little faith.
Kwa sababu na imani
chache. I tell you the truth.
Nawaambia ukweli.
If you have faith.
Kama mngelikuwa
na imani. As a mustard seed. You can say to this mountain.
Naweza ambia mlima.
Move from here.
Ngoka.
And to there.
And
it will move.
Na utaongoka.
And nothing shall be impossible for you.
Hakuna ambacho hakitawezekana
kwako. Nothing shall be impossible for you.
Hakuna ambacho hakitawezekana
kwako. I say nothing shall be impossible for you. 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 Nothing shall be impossible for me. Someone lift up and say, and nothing shall be impossible for me. Nothing shall be impossible for me. Nothing shall be impossible for me. Now, what is faith of a mustard seed?
Imani ya mbegu ya haradali ni ipi?
It is active faith.
Ni imani inayotenda kazi.
Amen. Now, the mustard seed is the smallest.
Mbegu ya haradali ndio ndogo sana.
But it is alive.
Lakini ina uhai.
It is alive.
Ina uhai.
It is only waiting to be thrown in the soil.
Inangojea tu iwekwe mchangani.
And suddenly, though it is the smallest, it will become the biggest tree.
Ingawa ndio ndogo inafanyika mti ule mkubwa.
That is why it is called faith of the mustard seed. It is faith that is alive.
Hiyo ndio sababu inaitwa mbegu ya imani ya mbegu ya haradali ni mbegu iliyo.
That is why James can say.
Ndio sababu Yakobo anasema.
Faith without action is dead.
Imani bila matendo imekufa.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Faith.
Lakini
imani. Of a mustard seed.
Ya mbegu ya haradali.
Is faith that is alive.
Ni imani iliyo hai.
And with that alive faith.
Na imani hiyo iliyo hai.
It will take an action.
Itachukua kitendo.
Faith will take an action.
Imani itafanya kitendo.
That is what differentiates between active faith and dead faith.
Yo,
active faith, alive faith. It takes a step of faith. A step of faith is an action that is taking you towards what you are believing God for.
Hiyo ndio tofauti ya imani ya kutenda. Manake inakusukuma katika kile ambacho unaamini Mungu katika.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many are together with me? Blessed be the name of the Lord. And that one step of faith, it takes another. It takes another. And nothing shall be impossible for you. I declare to you today, as you master the spiritual environment by the power of faith, you are going to see everything subdued in your life. Whatever you believe God for, I declare it is possible. I declare it done for you.
Oh, yes.
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, even to our viewers,
yes.
We declare, let faith arise in your life, let faith arise for your situation, and let everything be possible for you in Jesus' mighty holy name.
Our viewer, I believe you have been blessed by the word of God, and I believe the Lord has spoken to you. Now I want to make a prayer for you if you have not received Jesus as your personal Savior. If you are there and you are saying, yes, I want to get saved, I would want to lead you in a prayer. Say after me, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I realize I am a sinner. But today, I repent all my sins. Forgive me and write my name in Lamb's Book of Life. I receive you in Jesus' name. Amen. I believe Jesus has saved you. From today, look for a church where the word of God is preached and go there and serve God. If you have any other need, I want to pray with you so that the Lord can meet you at the point of your need. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for my viewer. I pray that you minister to him or her
and that you are going to meet her at the point of her need. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Thank you for watching our program. Keep tuned. Our number is running down there at your screen. You can contact us, contact the pastor. We will minister to you accordingly. Thank you. Until next time, God bless you and keep you.